The icy tour is now over. So now what? Good morning, good afternoon, or good night, depending on when you're watching this. How's it going, guys? First off, I hope you're having a good day today. Hope your day's going well and hope it continues to go well. We're just going to get right into it, mainly because I am super exhausted. I've been up since 3:50 in the morning. Don't ask me why I was up so early. I just couldn't fall back asleep, and I've been doing stuff since. I've been up for 17 hours. It's currently 9 o'clock right now. I'm exhausted, so we're going to do a nice, quick 21 Pilot News episode. So let's get right into it. 21 Pilots finished up the Icy Tour in Seattle, Washington on Saturday night. And since then, people have been talking about their favorite Icy Tour moments. But one moment from the Seattle show had a lot of people talking, because for the first time throughout this entire run, even for TakeOver, 21 Pilots added a different intro onto car radio. Check it out. This freaked a lot of people out because it was something different, and a lot of people were analyzing this, and a lot of people said that this was a regional at best tease to fit with the whole going back in time, with Tyler acknowledging regional at best during the Every Era medley, as well as adding older songs such as Guns for Hands and including a regional at best era intro video halfway through the tour. A lot of people said this tease sounded a lot like Ruby. I saw a lot of people say that. However, that has been debunked. And yes, it was technically a regional best tease, but it was just a tease, a car radio, and specifically the stems from car radio. Check it out right here. So it's not a regional at best at all, but still people speculate that regional at best will be mastered, with Tyler acknowledging the past more and more. A lot of people speculate the regional at best remastered. However, we do know that new 21 Pilots material is coming to streaming services. By new, I mean new streaming services, because the MTV Unplugged album is set to come out within the end of this year. Tyler confirmed so himself, and this is just a reminder that it's going to be released either middle of this month, November, or December, but sometime by the end of this year. And speaking of new music, a reminder that Skylar Accord of the Psyband is releasing his first song as a solo project on September 28th, called Knew It All Along. You can pre-save it using the link down in the description box below. I am very excited when it comes out. We will be doing a reaction video on the channel, and I'm going to try to learn on guitar, because I already know it's going to be a fun one, because Skylar is an incredible musician.
It's a pretty backdrop as ever to remind everybody that my first single, Knew It All Along, comes out September 28th, and you should pre-save it, and the link is in my bio. But anyways, look, it's a Bay Bridge. Cool, right?
And sticking on the theme of Psyband members' other projects, Dr. Jesse Bloom, the trumpet player, accordion player, and keyboardist of the Psyband, and Bowtie Aficionado, has launched his own bowtie shop. He launched this quite a bit ago. However, I just forgot to talk about it on the channel, so what better time than now? Currently, you can get 3 different bowties, all featured right here, or you can get all 3 as a $50 bundle. I personally ordered one of the bow ties because I think they're super cool, and I think bow ties do look cool. So we're gonna be doing an unboxing of that when it gets here.
Jesse, guess what?
3 lights are lit, but the 4th one, it is out.
Smash the bottle, you won't.
And of course, now that the Icy Tour has come to an end, everyone is going to be on a month-long break until it is time to go down to Brazil in November for GP Week alongside the Killers. People are speculating what this show is going to be. People are speculating this is going to be like the Icy Tour. People are speculating this is going to be like the festival shows we had earlier this year, or a hybrid of both. Personally, I can see it being like the festival shows earlier this year, here with the sprinkle elements of the Icy Tour, such as adding guns for hands, taking out the usual campfire, and putting in all of the medley of their songs they were doing, such as The Hype, Nico and Niners, Judge, so on and so forth. I don't think they would do the Every Era medley down there, but I think that it is quite possible that they could do a collab with The Killers on something. I don't know what that thing would be, but I think it'd be pretty cool. But I'd love to know your predictions down in the comment section below. We'll talk about this more when we get closer to GP week date. And of course, after that, 21 Pilots have not announced anything yet. Most likely they are going to be taking a little bit of break because Thanksgiving will be coming up. Then it's going to be Christmas. And Tyler, of course, now has two children. So Tyler definitely probably wants to spend some good quality time with his two daughters now, as well as his wife Jenna, and Josh maybe wants to spend time with Debbie and other members of the side band, go on do other side projects. That being said, a lot of people are speculating that the side band is done. People are saying that they could be done. Not a lot of people, but there are some rumors out there that this could be it, which if it is, a good run for those guys. I'm not saying anything themselves. I want the side band to continue because I think all those guys are really cool and great musicians, but who knows what the future holds. And that's all I have. Basically, I'm just reminding you of things today and just talking about some new things, some speculatory things. I'm tired. I'm going to get some sleep. I'm exhausted. I have to wake up early tomorrow because the car is getting inspected. Oh boy. Anyway, guys, I'm off to bed now. Goodbye. And good day, more importantly, have a good day. I'll see you tomorrow with something more informative. See ya.